Welcome back to the show. Well, billions worth of coal and gas projects are now in doubt after the federal government struck a deal with the Greens to deliver its emission reduction pledge, but it could push power prices higher. Join us to discuss Minister for Government Services and the NDIS, Bill Shorten, and 3AW's Neil Mitchell. Morning, guys.
Morning.
Nice to see you. Bill, to you first up, if we are restricting supply, there is only one way for prices to go, right?
I'm confident this is a good news announcement. The amount of carbon that we're going to take out of the emissions is the equivalent of taking two-thirds of our cars off the road by 2030. So I'm confident there'll be energy for the future, but I'm also confident that we'll have more renewables in the mix.
OK, good that, news. That wasn't answering the question about power prices. Industry leaders say it can only be born out of by households. Do you have some miracle power supply you're going to conjure from your magical renewable hat in the meantime?
No, but I think there's a fair bit of scaremongering going on here. The reality is that the Greens political party want us to ban all new coal and gas projects. That's not going to happen. I think what we've got is a path which has been negotiated with industry, negotiated across the parliament, and I think Australians expect us to take action. I'm not losing my hair over the issue of scaremongering on power prices.
But it is going to go up, right?
Well, I do think that if you want to look at what's driving power prices, I think there's other factors in the system, like the illegal Russian invasion of
Bill.
Ukraine.
Right,
no, genuinely, you're putting forward a proposition. You're putting forward a proposition that somehow this is bad news, and I don't agree with you.
Neil, off you go.
I would suggest that whenever the Greens are happy with something, the average person suffers, and the Greens are happy with this. Bill, as a representative of the government, but not on this case.
Sorry.
What about some truth? As a member of the government, can you guarantee prices of power and gas will not go up? One, can you guarantee that major projects, gas projects, will not be cancelled? The industry is saying this will happen. Can you guarantee us prices won't go up?
OK, Neil, straight down the barrel of the camera to you. I think what you just said in the first part was absurd. The reality is that with prices, what's driving prices are other factors. We have had a dysfunctional energy market in Australia for the last 10 years. It's been dysfunctional because the Libs and the Conservatives and some of the commentators just say no action on climate, and as a result, we haven't had new investment in our energy grid. This clears the way for new investment. So I actually think that this is
deflecting, Bill.
No, I'm not deflecting at all, mate.
Can you guarantee prices won't go up?
Neil, I can guarantee that we've done in terms... Well, hang on a second, mate. You ask the question, I'll give you the answer. I can guarantee that our measures are going to, in the long term, help make sure that we have reliable, secure energy for the future.
But we don't know how much.
The problem is, for the last 10 years... People like yourself have ruled the roost on climate policy, and it's got us precisely
nowhere. Bill, you also promised before the last election, to be fair to Neil, that you would reduce power prices. But now this deal is going to guarantee that that won't happen, and that prices, they have to go one way if you cut supply.
Well, first of all, what we said is that by 2025 we'd lower prices. Do I wish the Russians hadn't invaded Ukraine? Absolutely, mainly for the Ukrainians, but also a little bit for energy prices.
This deal makes it worse, though, right?
No, I think that this deal actually provides runway for new investment. I don't know if you had a good look at our energy poles and wires and supply system over the last 10 years. Coal power stations have been exiting the market. We haven't had replacement energy investment. The other point that Neil said, he had two issues. One was about new coal and gas. The Greens wanted us to ban new coal and gas. We didn't. We haven't. What it'll mean is that our facilities will have to...
The industry says you have.
Oh, well, OK, the industry
never
likes...
Is the industry making all this up? Seriously. You say they're scaremongering. Are you really saying they're making it all up? They're just trying to scare us. I'm saying they are scaremongering.
I am saying they're scaremongering, and I'm glad you're putting the industry's viewpoint, but what the Parliament's doing is putting the nation's viewpoint. When are people going to realise that we have to take action on climate?
OK, but you can't go around saying that you're going to...
When are you going to realise we've got to pay bills?
That's the point.
I understand that, Neil. I live in the real world too. Don't worry about that.
The point about it is you're sort of conservative, but you and I are paid enough.
We can afford it.
Yeah, sure, and that's great. But the point about it is that the sort of head in the sand, do nothing on climate attitude, well, gee, that's been a success for the last 10 years, hasn't it, Neil?
I'm not arguing. That's not what I'm arguing, Bill. You know I'm not arguing that. I'm saying.
Well, you know that I'm not arguing.
Is it going to put up prices? Let's be honest with people. Is it going to put up prices? It must.
I actually think there are other factors which drive prices more. Let's be honest. And furthermore, if we don't have a reliable investment marketplace and clear rules, what's going to happen is that if we keep going down your path, we're going to have this same argument in 3 and 6 years, and we're going to wish then that we had done this now.
All right, guys, at the end of the day, it is going to mean that in the short term, at the very least, people need to get used to the idea of paying more for their power. That can't be under any question.
A landmark climate agreement between the federal government and the Greens will take aim at the country's biggest polluters. Federal politics reporter Rhys D'Alessandro joins us with more. Rhys, good morning to you. Could this deal drive up costs for households?
Well, that's certainly what the gas industry and the federal opposition are arguing, Brooke. These changes will see the country's 215 biggest emitters forced to slash their emissions by 5% each year. But the gas industry is warning the new laws, once passed, could drive up costs for households and businesses. Despite the reaction, the government says it's got the balance right.
I think what we've got is a path which has been negotiated with industry, negotiated across the parliament, and I think Australians expect us to take action. I'm not losing my hair over the issue of scaremongering on power prices.
The Greens had been negotiating a number of other demands with Labor, including a total ban on new coal and gas projects. The government did not agree to that, but 13 amendments were agreed to, changes the Greens say will stop about half of the 116 new coal and gas projects already in the pipeline, Brooke.
OK, thanks, Rhys.